Hi there. Welcome.
Countdown for Lok Sabha elections clearly has begun. And each political party seems to be making these tall claims that they are the ones who know exactly what is on the minds of young first-time voters. We also want to know, what is this connect which these political parties talk about between Youngistan and Hindustan's political class? What better way to find that out rather than going to all top colleges across Delhi University and asking students how much they actually know about the present-day political ecosystem? Here we are today at the Ramjas College. Let's find out how much do the students know about the present-day politics. Good morning, everybody. How are we today? Welcome to the surprise test. Welcome, Team Ramjas College. Thank you so much. Great to see you folks. Loud round of applause, firstly, for all of you. Right. So what we've done is that we've organized this quiz contest split into three rounds where we'll test your awareness of the political ecosystem. How much you actually know about political parties. We've got three teams here. Team Roti, Team Kapda and Team Makan. Any guesses why we have called all of you team Roti, Kapda and Makan?
Because Roti, Kapda, Makan are the basis of politics.
Basis of politics. Very good. That's the basis of politics is what we're trying to figure out. Since all of you are, you know, first-time voters, many of you would have questions on your mind, who to vote for, who not to vote for. Best thing to do now is to figure out how much you yourself actually know before you make up your mind on who to vote for and how you will end up having an influence on the road to 2019. So let's straight away kick off. The first round is Know Your Politics. In this round, each right answer will get you 10 points, right? Every past question, which if the right answer is given by a team, you will get 5 points on that past question. So everybody ready?
Yes.
Yeah?
Yes.
Can I get a louder yes?
Yes.
Yes, good. On that note, let's straight away kick off with the first question. And the first question goes to Team Roti. Who is the author? Who is the author? It's a very simple question. Who is the author of The Accidental Prime Minister? The book called Accidental Prime Minister. Do I need to give you options?
Sanjay Baru.
Well done, straight answer. Right. Question number two is for Team Kapda. Who was the union minister who introduced the Footwear Design and Development Institute Bill in 2017 in the Lok Sabha? Your four options are as follows. Option number one, Piyush Goyal. Option number two, Prakash Javadekar. Option number three, Smriti Rani. And option number four, Nirmala Sitharaman. Who is the minister who introduced this Footwear Design Bill? Your time starts now. Team Kapda. You guys can consult amongst yourselves. Okay, she has the answer. Just stand.
Piyush Goyal.
Piyush Goyal. Do you know in 2017 what was the mantralaya for Piyush Goyal?
I don't know, but I have read somewhere it's Piyush Goyal.
Are you sure? Shall I lock that answer?
Yes, yes, yes.
Absolutely? Yeah. Wrong answer. Question goes to Team Makan. Okay, Team Makan.
Smriti Rani.
Smriti Rani. What was the mantralaya for Smriti Rani in 2017?
External minister.
External affairs?
No. Union
Textile.
Minister.
Textile.
Union.
Textile minister.
Textile minister.
Are you sure?
Yes.
She also held on to information and broadcasting for a while. Smriti Rani.
She was textile minister.
INB minister cannot do this footwear design bill. Right? You still want to go with Smriti Rani?
Yes. Yes.
Wrong answer. Okay. Question passes to Team Roti. Time is going. Time is going. Anyone has the answer? You have the answer? Do you have the answer? Okay. Okay. She has the answer. She has the answer. Okay. Buzzer is gone. All right. All of you have missed your opportunity. The correct answer in 2017 is Nirmala Sitharaman. Nirmala Sitharaman was a defense minister, but Nirmala Sitharaman, before she became the defense minister, she was the commerce minister. So as commerce minister, she moved this bill. Okay, let's move on to the next question. And this question is for Team Makan, right? This is an interesting one. All of you are political science students here in Team Makan? Okay, this you must know because this was a very, very important milestone in the last couple of years. Which political party defeated the BJP in the Kerala bipolls which were held last year? Team Makan, your time starts now. Which political party defeated the BJP in the famous Kairana bipolls in Western UP? Who has the answer? Who has the answer? Your options are SP, BSP, Rashtriya Lok Dal, and the Indian National Congress. This question should be answered without any options according to me. You have the answer quickly.
Rashtriya Lok Dal.
Who was the candidate, do you know? But are you sure it's Rashtriya Lok Dal? Who's the president of Rashtriya Lok Dal? Ajit Jogi? Who said Ajit Jogi? Ajit Jogi is in Chhattisgarh. Do you know who's the president of the Rashtriya Lok Dal? You don't know. It's Ajit Singh. But you want to stay with that answer? Sure? Right answer. Well done. Okay. Right, let's move on to the next part of our first round. The questions so far were about contemporary politics, what has happened in the last couple of years. We now move on to political history. Team Roti, your question about political history. Who is the president of the Nationalist Congress Party? Your options are Krishna Patel, Amar Singh, Ram Vilas Paswan, Sharad Pawar. Who is the president of the NCP?
Sharad Pawar.
Sharad Pawar?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Not Praful Patel?
I'm sure.
Not Supriya Sule?
No.
Okay, Sharad Pawar. Right answer. That was a straight giveaway. Well done. Next question. Team Kapda. Are you guys science students here or are you guys political science students? Political science students here. Now, you guys, you should be able to close your eyes like this and give me the answer to this one. Who was the first law minister of India? Bharat ka pehla kanun mantri kaun tha? Bina option ke batao. Kaun batayega bina option ke? I'll give you 5 more points if you give me without options. Tell me.
B.R. Ambedkar.
B.R. Ambedkar. First law minister, right?
Yeah.
What's your name?
Chitra.
Chitra. Well done. Well played. Well done. Okay, team Makan, your next question. Which was the first party to ever form a government in the state of Karnataka? The linguistic state of Karnataka in South India, which was the first party which formed a government in the linguistic state of Karnataka? Your options are BJP, CPI, the Janata Dal Secular, or the Congress Party. Team Makan, your time starts now. Is he the only one who has the answers? Anyone else here who has the answers? Anyone else wants to have a go?
CPI.
CPI? Yeah. In Karnataka?
Yeah.
Sure?
Yeah.
Absolutely certain?
Yeah.
Anyone else has the answer? Wrong answer. Team Roti, which was the first party to ever form a government in the state of Karnataka? Time is going.
INC.
INC. Whose answer is that? Is that your answer? Is that his answer?
It's a team answer.
It's a team answer.
Yes.
So Team Roti is convinced it's INC?
INC.
Are all of you convinced? It's an Indian National Congress Party. Right answer. Well done. So with that, we come to the end of round one. At the end of round one, the scores are as follows. Team Makan. Team Makan is making progress, but rather slowly. 10 points to Team Makan. Good round. Well played so far. Team Kapda, Chitra is playing well, so you got 15 points. Well done. But the team which is really playing well is Team Roti, which has got all right answers. 25 points to Team Roti. Well played, Team Roti. Right, time now for our second round. This is the audiovisual round. Now, the rules for this round are as follows. First part of this round, you will hear some audio clips, some speeches. You have to tell me the name of the person, or I may ask you to give me the context why that speech was being made by the person who made that speech. 5 points for an answer on a past question, 10 points for a clear-cut answer. And don't look towards me for giving you any clues on this one, okay? So that's why we call it exciting. Is everybody ready for this?
Yes.
All right. Team Roti, your first question in our audio visual round. Listen to this clip and then tell me who is the leader that we're talking about.
If we were racist, why would have all the entire South, which is complete around, you know, Tamil, you know, Kerala, you know, Karnataka and Andhra, why do we live with them? We have black people around us.
Okay, Team Roti, your time starts now. 10 seconds to give me the answer. Okay, she has the answer.
Is it Subramanya Swami?
Subramanya Swami. Which party is Subramanya Swami?
BJP.
From? BJP. Yeah. Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm sure.
Wrong answer. Okay, Team Kapda. Who is the leader that we're talking about? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Gone. Okay, Team Akan. Okay, yes.
So this speech was made by Mr. Tarun Vijay.
Sure?
He's the one, yes.
He's the one.
Yes, sir.
Okay, right answer. Well done. So this was Tarun Vijay. And Tarun Vijay was making the speech trying to suggest that it's wrong to accuse India of being a racist country. Right, Team Kapda. Listen to this statement which is being made, and you have to again tell me the name of the politician who's making the statement. Clear? Please listen to this statement carefully.
I propose we will install a new prime minister in Delhi. I propose the candidature of Rahul Gandhi from Tamil Nadu. Rahul has got the ability to defeat the fascist, Nazist Modi government.
Okay, your time starts now, Team Kapda. I propose the candidature of Rahul Gandhi. And the statement itself has a clue. If you heard that statement. 9 seconds gone, 10 seconds over. Team Akan, who wants to have a go? Is there anyone else here in this team? Why is it that each team only has one person who has the answers?
Sir, this speech was made by Mr. Stalin. He is the president of DMK.
The president of the?
DMK.
The DMK. Are you sure?
Yes.
It was not made by Mr. A. Raja?
No.
Stalin, you know, struggles with his English.
Yes, sir.
Yeah?
Sir, he seemed to be struggling.
He seemed to be struggling. Yes, okay. Sir. Well done. Right answer. Okay. So, Team Kapda, the question got passed to Team Makan. Team Makan, the next question comes to you. Listen to this speech. And now you need to tell me, when was the speech made? Okay? Because you may know, for sure you will know who is the person who is making the speech. You have to tell me, when was the speech made?
Sab kah rahe hain, humne gajab kaam kiya. Karoron ka munafa har ek saam diya. Phal saalon se ab dega. Paudha jo lagaya hai. Sevak. I will try to translate myself in English here.
Right, everybody knows who this person is, right? Who's the person that we're talking about? Lalu Yadav, one and only Lalu Yadav. When was Lalu Yadav speaking? Do you know? Does anyone here has an answer? Do you guys have an answer? Yeah, lady in violet, yes. Come on.
Was it when he was accused of the scam?
Does he sound like someone who's defending himself? He sounds like someone who's making a policy statement. Why would he be defending himself?
I guess then not.
Okay, right. The question passes. Team Roti. Team Roti. You have the answer? Anyone else? I'm looking for some more participation from your team. You guys have the answer or should I go to him? Go to him. Okay, he's the boss. Right, go ahead.
Sir, this is of the times when Lalu Prasad Yadav was the railway minister and railway had benefited, like it was the first time since independence.
Which year? Which year are we talking about?
Sir, in the regime of UPA.
Which year?
Sir, year is...
UPA 1 was between 2004 and 2009. UPA 2 was between 2009 and 2014. Which year is Lalu
Yadav?
Sir, it
is of the times between 2006-2007.
Like. 2006-2007?
Yes, but the context is when the railway was benefited and he was the railway minister.
Okay, let's give it to you because yes, Lalu Yadav was the railways minister and this was delivered in the year 2008, just before the Lok Sabha elections in
2007 was close.
Fine, no, the right answer, we'll give it to you. Well, at least you got the context right. So, well done. So, with that, we come to an end of our audio round. We will now move to the second part of this round, which is the most exciting round, and for me, my favorite round. We call it the memology round, right? Where what we are going to do now, we'll place some memes on the screen. And you will have to give me the context. Why was that meme prepared? Clear? Everybody clear? 10 points for right answer, 5 points for past answer. Your first meme comes up now. Now my question is, which debate in Parliament inspired this meme? This meme was created when there was a debate that was taking place in Parliament. Team Roti, your time starts now. Which debate in Parliament prompted this meme? Anyone wants to have a go? Any guesses? Your time is running up, time is running up, time is running up, gone. Okay, time's over. Team Kapra. Your time's up, 10 seconds gone. Team Kapra. Team Kapra, anyone there? In the whole group, kisi ko to aata hoga. Okay, Team Kapra also gone. Team Kapra also gone. Now, Team Makan. Rahul Gandhi, Narendra Modi, you know who this woman is. Right?
South Indian actress.
South Indian actress.
I don't know.
Okay. But what's the context?
This was when there was the no confidence motion that was passed. Like
when
it was
this move? When was the no confidence motion moved?
June of 2018, sir.
June of 2018.
Yes, sir.
Okay. And who won that no confidence motion?
BJP won.
BJP won the no confidence motion. All right. Right answer. Well done. It was a very simple question. That's Rahul Gandhi, the famous wink. Yeah. And that's Priya Warrior. Another famous wing. Okay, Team Kapra, your question. Look at this meme carefully, the next one which is coming up, and you have to tell me the biopic and the person on whom this biopic was made. Yeah, who knows it? You know it? Okay, Mike, speaking of the mic.
Bal Thackeray? Yeah.
Are you sure? Yeah, engineer startup plan after graduation. What startup did Bal Thackeray create? Was he a startup creator?
Sangh Parivar.
Bal Thackeray created Sangh Parivar? Which
party? Shiv Sena.
Shiv Sena. Is everybody clear? Yeah, Bal Thackeray never created a startup, but you're telling me he created Shiv Sena. Shiv Sena. All right, right answer. Well done. So there is this biopic which is being made on Bal Thackeray, and this meme was created because of the fact that there was a biopic which was being created. All right, the next meme which is coming up. Team Makan, you guys are ready? Yeah, you've seen Team Roti, you've seen Team Kapra. Your time comes up now. What political event does this meme refer to? That's Narendra Modi, that's Lalu Yadav, and that's Nitish Kumar. What would have happened that led someone, some creative mind, to come up with a meme like this? Your time starts now. Who has the answer? You have the answer.
Sir, when Nitish Kumar ji ne jo hai Lalu Yadav ji ko chhod kar NDA government ke wo alliance ko join kiya tha.
Tab kis saal hua tha wo?
17, sir.
Are you sure? You certain on this one?
Sir, yeah, absolutely sure.
Absolutely sure. Yeah, okay, good. Absolutely correct answer. So with that, the audio visual round also comes to an end. I can see that Team Makan has got itself back. Its mojo is back. Well done. Well played. Huge round of applause for everybody so far. So at the end of round two, the scales have tilted dramatically. At the end of round one, Team Roti was the winner. At the end of round two, Team Makan is the winner. Well done. So well played, Team Makan. You guys are now at 35 points. Team Roti is on 30 points. Well played, Team Roti. Keep it going. You guys are still in the hunt. And Team Kapra. Team Kapra also not too far off. It's just a matter of getting one question right. 25 points right now to Team Kapra. So now we come to round three. This is the final round, folks. This is the round which will determine who's going to win and who's going to lose this quiz contest. Two parts to our final round, guess who and rapid fire. The exciting part about this round is that now we are going to ask each team to come up with one representative. So firstly, Team Roti, who's your representative? Okay, stand.
I am Sohel from Team Roti.
Okay, Team Kapra, who's your representative?
Chitra.
All right. Team Makan, keep standing, Chitra. Team Makan, who's your representative? So
that's me. My name is Anand.
Anand, okay. Are you guys ready?
Yes.
Teams, you have confidence in your representatives?
Yes.
All right. So here are the rules for this event. And the rules are very, very important. I will be giving you a question each to each of you. Right? There are 5 clues to these questions. If you give me the right answer on the first clue, 25 points. If you don't give me the right answer, then we will be deducting points in this round. Every time you move to the next clue, the number of points come down by 5. So 25 points, first clue answer, 20 points, second clue answer, 15 points, third clue answer. Are we clear?
Yeah.
Yes. Everyone clear?
Yes.
Can I get a loud yes?
Yes.
Okay, so on that note, let's straight away kick off question number one of our last round. Sohail, who is the politician who has authored 16 books? Politician in India who has authored 16 books, and that politician puts this claim on that politician's website. Your time starts now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Shashi Tharoor.
16 books he's written. Are you sure? If you get the wrong answer, 5 points gone.
Yes.
Right. Yes. Shall I lock it?
Yes.
Shall I lock it, team? Can I get a yes from everybody?
Yes.
Yes. Good answer. Correct answer. Well done. So Shashi Tharoor is the politician. We all know his English, right? And we all know how erudite he is in his diction. He's written 16 books, and I think by the time he retires, he may well have written 50 books. All right, Team Kapda, please bear in mind only 5 seconds, huh? These are not 10 seconds. So 25 points, first clue answer, 5 seconds. But if you get the wrong answer, 5 points gone. Ready, Chitra?
Yes, sir.
Team Kapda, ready?
Yes.
Are you ready to back Chitra?
Yes.
Okay, your question. Who is the politician? Who is the politician on whose life a movie was made, and Aishwarya Rai Bachchan played the part of that politician in that movie, which was made by Mani Ratnam? Who am I talking about? Your time starts now. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Jayalalitha. Jayalalitha.
Jayalalitha. Jayalalitha was who?
She was a politician.
Politician? Was she a leader, chief minister?
Yeah, she was a leader.
MLA? Who was she? MP?
She was a chief.
She was
the chief minister of Tamil Nadu.
Speaking of the mic.
She was the chief minister of Tamil Nadu.
The chief minister of Tamil Nadu.
Yeah.
And was she an actress?
She was late chief minister of Tamil Nadu.
Yes. Was she an actress before she became chief minister?
Yeah, she was an actress.
Sure?
Yes.
Okay, good answer, right answer. Your friend gave you a good clue. So it's a team game. See, she gives a clue and that clue comes quickly down to Chitra and she gets it right. All right, so 25 points to Team Kapda as well. What a sport, what a game today. Team Akan. Are you guys ready? Yeah? Anant is ready?
Yeah, absolutely.
All of you are ready? The person sitting at the back gets the right answer this time in Team Kapda. Let's see whether the back benchers ensure that the front bencher gets it right. Your question, oh boy, this is a giveaway. Who is the politician that I'm talking about who was born as Ajay Singh Bisht? Who is the politician that I'm talking about?
Yogi Adityanath.
Yogi Adityanath, which state does he represent?
UP.
Sure?
Yeah, yeah,
he's
sure.
The chief minister, right?
Yeah, sure.
What's his nickname? Does anyone know his nickname? So
he's known by Yogi. Yogi.
Yeah. He's known as Maharaji, but good answer, correct answer. Well done, well done, well played. So Team Roti, Team Kapda, Team Makan, all of you have got 25 points each. Lovely. So another good round of applause. Okay. Now we come to the very last section of our concluding round. We call it the rapid fire trivia. In this section, all the three of you, aap tino ko, please come here to the blackboard now. All of you, Team Roti, Team Kapda, Team Makan. Now the way this will work is as follows. That I will be asking your representatives one question each in a gap of 5 seconds. So to give me the right answer, you exactly have 5 seconds. Now all of you can look towards your teammates. You can take whatever guidance consultation that you want, but you have exactly 5 seconds to answer the question. Right answer gets you 10 points. Wrong answer gets you -5 points. Right? Okay, Ramjas College, are we clear?
Yes.
All of you?
Yes.
All right. So your time and your first question starts now. Which is that one state in India which has the maximum number of reserved seats for scheduled castes? Your time starts now. Which state in India has the maximum number of scheduled caste seats reserved? 1, 2. Okay, point over. Gone. Second question. Nobody gets it. Who is India's longest serving Prime Minister? Who is India's longest serving Prime Minister? Okay, let's move to question number 3. We'll give you the answers later at the end, right? The 2014 elections The 2014 elections in India, when Narendra Modi became the Prime Minister, in how many phases was that election contested? How many phases in 2014 Lok Sabha elections? How many phases in 2014 Lok Sabha elections? Okay, time over. Next question. Who is India's youngest ever Prime Minister? Who is India's youngest ever Prime Minister? Who is India's youngest ever Prime Minister? All right. Time's up, time's up, time's up. Okay. That was done, that was good. Everyone has got three answers. All right. Okay, so let's take it one by one. Let's see who's got the answers right, okay? The first question that I had asked was, which state in India has the maximum number of seats reserved for scheduled castes? Right? And none of you know the answer. How many of you come from UP? 1, 2, 3. Okay. So you guys should have known. It's the state of Uttar Pradesh. The state of Uttar Pradesh, which has the highest concentration of scheduled castes. The biggest population of scheduled castes in India is in UP, 17 seats, just so that you know for the next time. So none of you knew the answer. None of you could get that right. Okay. The second question which we had raised was, who is India's longest serving Prime Minister? Longest serving Prime Minister, Team Makan says Manmohan Singh, Team Kapra says Jawaharlal Nehru, and Team Roti, you also go by Jawaharlal Nehru. Alright, the right answer is indeed Jawaharlal Nehru. So well done, Team Kapra and Team Roti. Jawaharlal Nehru was the Prime Minister for a total of 6,130 days. Right, the next question. So what is the answer which has been given by all of you to the next question? What's that number that you've written? 4. The question was, how many phases was the 2014 Lok Sabha elections contested in? How many seats did the BJP win in 2014?
It won 282.
282 seats. You remember that, yeah. Right? But none of you remember how many phases this election was contested in, because the 2014 Lok Sabha elections was fought in 9 phases. In 9 phases. So all of you got that wrong. Then the final question, who is India's youngest Prime Minister? And your answer is, Anand? Rajiv Gandhi. And you are, Chitra?
Rajiv.
You are?
Rajiv Gandhi.
You are Rajiv Gandhi. So Chitra says this is the one that you got from her.
No. Oh. I made
you got from them. Oh, consensus from the team.
Yes.
I made.
It's the right answer. So well done, all of you. All of you, you've got the right answer. Rajiv Gandhi indeed was the youngest Prime Minister in India at the age of 40. So Rahul Gandhi, even if he ends up becoming the Prime Minister, is certainly not going to beat his father's record, because Rahul Gandhi has already crossed the age of 40. Well done, well played, all of you.
Thank you so much.
You can go back to your seats. Okay, so that was some exciting quizzing from all of you. Time now for us to look at our final scores. Any guesses who's won this contest? Who's won this contest? At the end of round 2, Team Makan was clearly ahead. Is Team Makan still ahead? You guys feel you're not ahead. In third place is the team which was actually number 1 at the end of round 2. Team Makan, you slipped all it needed, and that's why I said at the beginning of this round, please listen to questions carefully. If you'd got one question right in this final contest, in this final section, you'd have been on top of the charts. You're at 60 points. Well played anyways, well played. Good effort. And Team Kapra, from 15 in the first point to 25 in the second round to 65 in third round. You guys are runner-up. Very well played. Very well played. At the end of this third round, indeed Team Roti, well done. So, Team Roti stands at 70 points. Well played, well played, well played, Team Roti. On that note, as Ramjas College totals 195 points. Very well played, Team Ramjas College. Let's see whether any other college in Delhi University can beat this performance which has been put up today by Team Ramjas College. And I do hope that all of you continue with this great quizzing and your inquisitiveness about politics and political ecosystem in India. On that note, that's it, and class dismissed.